Okay, so we're going to talk about the Lean Canvas model. And it's a business plan that is one page long. And it's all on one page. It has a lot of text boxes that you're going to fill in. We're going to fill those in today. And it's simple. You do this before you make the big, great, big, long business plan that we already made for our food trucks a few weeks ago. So that's what we're going to use. That's what we're going to go off of is our food trucks that you guys created. And you're going to use that information and we're going to plug it in there. And so the businesses will use these to make sure that a business is even going to be viable or worth pursuing. All right, so okay, this is what the Lean Canvas model looks like. If you pulled that up in your Google Docs, it's going to look like that. I made one earlier that did not look correct, that would not format correctly in your Google Docs. So if you'll go back to your Google Classroom, this one's in there. It says a copy. It's in your, I just put it in there a few minutes ago. All right, so how many steps are there in the Lean Canvas model? There's 9 steps, but they're super simple and quick because we already have this information and we're gonna plug it in and we can add to it. All right, so number 1 is problem, 2 is customer segments, 3 is unique value proposition. Those are the 3 we're gonna do today. All right, so I'm using a business concept of an international taco truck. And I have name TBD in there because it's to be determined. All right, problem number 1. What problems do our customer segments have? How can we fill a gap where there's a need for in our target market? So, this one says there are many taco food trucks in our community, but there are not any taco trucks that serve global cuisine. So what would be something around here? Because we know we don't really have taco trucks, right? So what would you put? Yeah. Just
so we do have taco trucks.
Well, we do, yeah. True, we have them in, but not in cereal. Where would you want to, okay, if you did, what's your food truck again? What was it?
Munchie-mobile. No.
Emily?
What was our food truck called? Delightful Treats.
Delightful Treats, and y'all had all this wonderful, yummy stuff. So what could you put? Because I don't know any food trucks that serve those kind of things in our being here in Fort Smith anywhere, do y'all? So you could say there are no food trucks in our community that serve desserts. That might be a problem. This would be a problem as to what our customers have. So they're not, and they're not open a lot. The bakeries, your hours might be different from what the bakery's hours were. Yeah. So like Sweet Boutique, like on Saturday, Sweet Boutique's only open till like what, 1 or something. So you might want to, that might be something you want to put. You might want to think about your hours, but these are all on this part of your business plan. On the number 1 column is just what problems do your customers have that your food truck could fill. Like you're filling a need. So you would say maybe like there's not any food trucks that serve desserts. There's not the hours. You might only look at the hours or the location or something like that on your problem. Okay, number 2 would be your customer segments. So who are target customers and who's going to buy our products? So mine says our target customers would not be people that only like American food. This is for an international taco truck. We need a customer that's considered a foodie or someone that's open to trying all different types of food. So I have down millennials, well-traveled people, thrill seekers, and maybe a social media influencer that does food reviews. So what are your customers? Who would be your customers? People who love sweets? Absolutely. What else? When you did it, what was your target market for your business plan? Do you remember? Like, was it? have suites, people who, maybe somebody needs, has a birthday or someone looking for, you know, there's all kinds of different ways you can put it. Alright, number three is a unique value proposition. So what's your story, what's your vision statement, and what's your mission statement? So a vision statement for the International Taco Truck would be, we will introduce our community to food outside of what they would normally try. We will show others a world of food, ingredients, and cuisine different from what they already know. They can explore the world without going too far from home. So I know that you guys have your vision statement. Emily, what was y'all's vision statement?
We want to serve amazing, one-of-a-kind treats to our small town, something that they can afford, enjoy, and always come back for. We would love to cater parties, events, etc., and our goal is to cater events that were stated to promote our company and get our name out.
Okay, good. So you can put your vision statement, and if you have your mission statement, do you have a mission statement too? Okay, what's your mission statement?
Our goal for our future is to be the best in Arkansas. We aspire to be like the best in the best.
Very nice. Okay, so I'll show you real quick on here where it's gonna go. So you're gonna start. It like works back and forth. This Lean Canvas does. So you're gonna do like number one will go right here on the problem. And it's on that either one that you choose. This is how it goes. So number one is the problem, and that's where you're gonna put what your the needs you're trying to fill right there, and then you'll go over to the other side, and this is where you're gonna put your target market, your customer segments. So who's gonna buy your product? Okay, here's a couple of different ways you can look at it. Who is going to buy my product, and who needs and will pay for my service? So that's number one. That's number two. Number three is putting down your tell your story. I tell a little bit about it. I like to bake sweets or whatever. Yours was the Munchie Mobile back there. I don't know what your story is. It's probably exciting, but what gives worth to your product or your service, and why should someone buy it, and what's your vision and mission statement? So you already have most of those things, like your vision. Your company description that you did at the beginning, I think, that would have some of this in there too. So let's do those three, and then we'll come back and we'll